Welcome to the 26th Billing Fun Run. It's organised by the National Street Rod Association and it's one of the premier events in Europe involving hot rods, and we're here to look around. I believe this is quite a famous van, Paul.
Yeah, it's an old drag car that a guy called Bob Swaymer built in the late 70s, and then he put it onto the street. And as it is now, it runs 11 second quarters, 125 mile an hour. It's got a 500 brake horse, big block Chevy in it. Yeah, pretty quick, yeah.
What are your plans today? What are you going to be up to today?
Just to sit around the sun, have a few beers with some friends and see some nice cars, hopefully.
So, Alan, you're a committee member of the NSRA. What's that?
The NSRA is the National Street Rod Association. It's the premier hot rod club in the UK. It's been formed for 26 years now, and we put a number of events on for our members. This event here has actually been held for 26 years now. This is the 26th year of it. And it's an event that we put on that the participants actually come along, they can show their cars, and we put different things on during the day. Yesterday we had some cruises into Northampton, which was attended by about 75 cars. So we drove along the car there, we stopped up for a picnic and we came back. We've had some other things happening today. We've actually had an event on how to polish cars, how to take care of cars. We've got some model dragsters running across in the background there. But primarily, it's enable our members to show the cars, as you see in the field here. What happens then is we actually have a number of categories that we judge these cars, and some of our sponsors actually bring some prizes forward as well. So about 4 o'clock, which is day two on the Sunday of the two-day event, we'll be having some prize giving. And a lot of these people are quite extroverts. We like to show the cars off. So it's the cumulative part of a really fun weekend.
Right. Are you an exhibitionist as well? Do you have a car yourself?
Yeah, I am a little bit, yeah. I've got a car over there. Although I must admit, I'm not too much extrovert because I didn't bother even washing it to put it in the show. but yeah, I think you need to be in this sport. These cars are very expensive and they're very high tech, you know, because normally they tend to be owner built. Very basic engineering, but all done by the owners. And that's what we like about it. It's a thing that we can actually really participate in, building, running, driving, and showing the cars.
Have you ever participated in a burnout? And can you tell me what is the point?
Well, strictly speaking, I'd have to deny that because burnouts tend to be frowned on a little bit, but they are lots of fun. And we did have some burnout contests yesterday under very safe circumstances. We had a blocked off road. And what a burnout does is just actually shows the power of the car. Where we actually have a car on a tarmac road with some water on the back wheels. Most of these cars have got things called line locks fitted, where we can actually apply the front brakes only and you can spin the back wheels, make some smoke and shout rubber.
Is this yours here? Tell us a bit about this pickup.
This is a firm's truck. It's based on a 32 Ford. Basically, the body works fiberglass and the rest is homemade. It's a mix and match of bits and pieces I found over the years, keeping it cheap. And I put a diesel engine in it for economy because we use it all the time. And everybody else uses it as well. It gets loaned out quite a bit. So
what about other cars? Have you got anything on the go at the moment?
I've got a 58 Chevy. I'm endeavouring to try and finish. But, you know, you spend all your time fixing customers' cars. What can you do? It's in the workshop. It's been here a year. And hardly anything's been touched so far.
So is this the job that you've always wanted to do since you were a kid?
I started off in the bike trade. I did bikes 24 hours a day. Got fed up. I thought, I'll try something else. So I did cars as a hobby. It seemed to be a bit successful. Someone picked up on it. Oh, can you do mine? Here I am, 17 years later. Got my own firm, couple of blokes working for me. It's all gone big.
So tell us a bit about the different types of hot rods you can get.
Well, they start off with the old ones, like the one behind us, 1930s to 1940s. They go up to 39 is the cut-off year, which all the ones before they got flat windscreen, so they're hot rods. After that, you get into customs, goes from 39 upwards. They become bigger, more rounded. Customs tend to go low rider in shapes, ever so low to the ground, big front area, all tapering off to the back. They look like they're going fast and they're standing still. From there on, it gets into more modern stuff. The theme at the moment, where it's just dying out really, is Pro Street, which is race influenced. You can more or less do it to any car. Biggest wheels you can get on the back, all inside the bodywork, plenty of engine, some sticking out the bonnet if you can get away with it. and that's about up to date. Really, there's mini trucks of a sideline, various sorts of trucks. There's lots of variations, but they're the main classifications, I would say.
So, Derek, you're from, or you own Triple Juice Hot Rods?
That's right, yes, I'm from Leicestershire.
Right, and I want a hot rod. What? How do you go about it? Where would I come to buy one?
Well, basically, you can come to me for the bodies. I do the 32 Roadster replicas. It's roughly about a third scale of a 32 Roadster. I'm just supplying the bodies, and I also know a chap of mine who can supply the chassis, steering, brakes, anything to do to build the whole kit up. Bodies come out at £125, and then the chassis, etc., all very reasonably priced, but on application.
Sold many at the show today?
I sold not at the moment because I've not been up that long actually. But
oh, I wonder why. We'll not talk about that.
No, we've just got a bit of a thick head, and this bright light doesn't help either. So, but yeah, they do sell very well, the 32s, because most people have been supplying 34s, and I'm the first one to be doing the 32 Roadsters, which are more popular anyway.
I believe you do helmets as well.
I certainly do. I certainly do. Yes, replica German helmets, all various colours and everything, but also I do all sorts of different body styles and all the extras that go with it as well.
So why the German? Is this just to keep the kids safe, or is it a bit of a joke?
No, this was just a Mickey take. I was around an auto jumble and I saw a German helmet, steel one, going cheap. So I thought, right, that'll do. I'll take a mould off that. So I'm quite known for taking moulds off anything that stands still long enough.
All right. Well, thank you very much, and have a good day.
I shall certainly try.
When you're looking for a new car, it's good to look at all the options. We're lucky enough to find a couple of guys here who are looking or in the market for a new car. So, but there's a bit of a difference. It's Tot Rods. Hello. What are your names?
I'm Daniel.
Jack.
Right, so let's have a look at what we've got here. What's your favourite one amongst all of these Tot Rods here?
Probably this purple one here with the flames on.
Yeah? Why is it your favourite?
Because I like the colours of all the flames, and it's wide enough for me and my brother to fit inside it.
Right, okay. What about this next one? Are you fussy? Are you quite fussy about what you choose?
We were going to have this one because it has... I could have gone in the back and Daniel could have driven the Tot Rod.
Yeah, that's a good idea, isn't it, to have that on the back? But you can always fit one anyway, I suppose, can't you?
Yeah. So, I quite like the colour of this one, I saw
the... Yeah, the purple, yeah. And the flames.
It might be that one instead.
So, what about this one? Is this... They seem to have bigger wheels on this.
Yeah, I like the colour green, and I like the pinstriping on it. These lines here.
You're quite into the colour. The colour's very important,
yeah,
is it?
Yeah, but it can't fit both of us in, so...
Well, that would be no good because you'd be fighting over it, wouldn't you? This is a bit of a sporty one.
Yeah.
Nice grille on the front.
Yeah, I quite like these red flamey bits on it, and it's got thicker than some of the wheels, but not as thick as the others,
yeah.
So it's quite a good car.
Now, where would you be when you do get a car? Where would you be driving it?
Probably around my road at the moment, because I'll be driving it around the block and everything.
Right,
probably.
So I believe, Jack, that your dad's building you one at the moment. What's that going to be like?
It's going to be like our dad's one, but it's going to be like it and have like a base bit at the back, but it'll only be able to fit like one in front and one at the back.
Oh, right.
And like three, and like my dad's had like three in the back and two at the front.
When's that going to be finished?
Probably about next year, because my dad doesn't really have the time to be able to finish it at the moment.
Well, you look...
Daniel might have to do it all, my new dad.
Yeah. Right then, so good luck with your Tot Rod. What colour is it going to be?
Black. We're probably going to have flames on it.
I see, you like your flames, don't you?
Yeah.
We're going to have a skull at the front and then flames coming along.
Wow, well.
Because my dad was going to put it on his truck, but Mum said no, so we're going to put it on our Tot Rod
instead. Because Mum doesn't like that type of stuff, so.
Do you think I'll be able to fit in it when it's done?
Yeah, probably, because it's going to be quite a big one.
All right, good. Well, I'll have to come round and have a go. We're just giving you a small taste of what went on this weekend. I mean, some of it we really couldn't put on camera. Believe me, it was such good fun. But if you want to see more, look out for some of your local shows, and I can guarantee you'll have a great time.